We are in Bet Hanina, a neighborhood in north of Jerusalem, very close to a Jewish neighborhood, Ramat Shlomo, at the distance. And we are here because in Bet Hanina many properties belong to Jews. The Jews own the properties and they are registered in the land registration, meaning there is no doubt who is the owner. And on the Jewish properties, like the property that we are right next to, this property here that is fenced, and properties that are illegal buildings in the land belong to the Jews, the municipality of Jerusalem is not destroying these illegal houses. And at the last few days, we heard the mayor of Jerusalem talking about that he's going to destroy illegal buildings in East Jerusalem if the government will destroy the buildings in Amona. And I'm saying, why are you connecting one to the other? Jerusalem, there's no question who is the owner. In the land registry, it's written under Jewish names. In Amona, there's a question, who is the owner and what the owner wants. Here, the owners are available, accessible, you can talk with them and see what they want. And you gave, once the municipality submitted a demolition or got a demolition order, there's no reason why the demolition is not happening by the municipality. In Amona, there is a basic question about ownership of the land and what's the status of the land, of ownership. Here there's no question. And the same thing like happening here, it's happening also in the Negev with the Bedouin. They are building on Jewish land. The Jews that own it are asking to demolish the illegal buildings, and unfortunately it's not being demolished by the municipality of Jerusalem.
It seems like that is absurd.
It is absurd, and it's not the only absurd we are facing in East Jerusalem. All the system of enforcing the law in East Jerusalem is one big hypocrisy. It's being enforced just on Jews and not on the Arabs or on the Muslims in East Jerusalem. Here we continue a bit west from where we were before in Bet Hanina, and we are now in an area that where we have, I'm talking about the Israel Land Fund, is representing Jews that are owning land right here, one on my right, one on my left. And on these areas, and we have a few other plots like these two, we are today already allowed to submit a building permit to build about 40 apartments. If you take to the left your camera, you will see there Shmuel HaNavi, Nebi Samuel, the grave of Shmuel HaNavi, Shmuel the prophet. If you go further to the left, you see this big neighborhood, this is Ramot neighborhood. And right there, behind of our property, this is our property, one of the properties that I'm talking about. This is where this house is. This is where we have a permit to build 16 apartments. Behind of it, you see at the distance, this is Ramat Shlomo, Jewish neighborhood. So, really what's happening here, we are at the beginning of a new Jewish settlement in north of Jerusalem, connecting Ramot in the west, Ramat Shlomo in our south, to Pisgat Ze'ev, that is to our east. This area is a crucial area for the future of Jerusalem, because we know that Ehud Olmert, when he was prime minister, and other politicians after him, talked few times already about giving this area, Bet Hanina, to our enemies in the Palestinian Authority. By building here a new Jewish neighborhood in affordable apartments, I'm sure, like we did in other places in East Jerusalem, we will change the reality. We will change also the way that politicians are looking on Bet Hanina. These two buildings, one here where Abu Mele family lives, another one there where Shoamri family lives, and also this new one that is in the middle, it's new one with where the red sign is. All of these three buildings are illegal. Illegal, that are built on Jewish land. The municipality of Jerusalem already received from court a demolition order few years ago, the lawyer of the owners, of the Jewish owners, asked the municipality to implement and to demolish these illegal buildings. And unfortunately, years are passing and still the buildings are still settled and built on the Jewish land. But I can tell you, we are not waiting to the municipality. We, instead of waiting for Bakat to bring his tractors to demolish
your vision,
we are first planning long term to build there. But we are also going very close, very soon, we are going to evacuate these Arabs. We got a eviction order. So I can say Bakat can continue talking, and the Jews, Be'ezrat Hashem, would continue working and doing things and pushing things on the ground. This is the way that things should be done, and this is the way that I promise we will continue.